I mean, the show started, but for some reason it's not recording. And now it starts fucking recording. Are you goddamn serious? Son of a bitch.
Just edit that in afterwards.
Fuck it. No. Fuck it. No, I don't even fucking care. Hello, everyone, and welcome to iReadit, bringing you your daily dose of the internet for Thursday, April 27th, 2017. I am Michael Schwahn.
And I'm Papa Filter.
What?
I fucking have to work with this pop filter the entire time. It's a piece of shit, and I hate it. So I'm Papa Filter.
You're... Why do you... Why do you do things?
It was fun.
Is that what it is? Is that what you're going to go with?
Yeah, actually, I am, because it's actually really fun.
Well, then.
You got a problem with that?
Shit. God damn it! Everything is fucked up and not working. Okay, it is working. Just I keep on like touching things and it's changing shit. It's fucking everything up.
Maybe you should stop touching things.
Yeah, but it's gonna be one of the, you know, this day has been real good so far, and it's all going to shit, and it's all your fault.
Why is it my fault?
Because I need someone to blame.
That's bullshit. Blame yourself, asshat.
No.
I'll kill you.
Do it.
Oh.
You don't have the strength.
You're right, I don't.
That's all right, I don't have the strength. What it honestly is I haven't eaten since like noon because I got home today and I just wasn't hungry. I'm sure I'll be fucking famished by the end of the show.
Yeah?
Yeah. I haven't done anything today. Like, I dicked around with like some Photoshop stuff and then I dicked around with a Wii U emulator and then that's it.
Did it work?
I'll talk about it more later.
Okay. That's nice. I did pretty much nothing as well. I got home and proceeded to nap instead of consolidating my Pokemon boxes like I should.
Cool.
But I got a hold of the other white Mike, and he's downstairs, and me and him are going to be figuring out songs for his podcast that he's working on.
Cool. Right on. Yeah. All right, let's get into some shit.
10.
Glasgow gym set to introduce fitness class consisting of nothing but sleeping for 45 minutes.
Dude, this is submitted by JamieJ64 to R Not the Onion.
Nathan's over there like, this was a gym regiment made for me.
Dude, right? Do you just let me sleep on massaging things that works my muscles over
no,
and
no,
over again?
It's just a bed. It's just a bed for you to sleep for 45 minutes, primarily pointed at parents because they don't normally get enough sleep, so you're going to go to the gym and take a nap.
But, actually really smart. That's really nice of them.
Yep, but the entire rooms that are designed for this are also situated in such a way that you will burn calories while you're sleeping.
How?
It has something to do with like the way that the beds are positioned as well as the general temperature in the room. It's one of the reasons that it's healthier to sleep in a cold room under warm blankets because it actually helps your body flow better internally and it can actually lead to just better health altogether.
How do I make my house colder during the summer then?
Air conditioner.
I can't even afford hair conditioner.
That's fair. Which is sad because that's one of the things you're not allergic to.
And it's like $3 a bottle.
Yeah, I know how you feel. Like we got paid today, or at least your check should be here today or tomorrow. And that disappeared real quick.
Yeah, it did, didn't it?
Yep. Because, like, I had the fat as fuck GCI bill last month and then, you know, had to buy computer parts and on the credit card. And so I had to pay some of that shit back. And so check's real sad.
Yeah.
Real sad. Yeah,
and it's the end of the month, you know?
Yep. Which means rent.
And not the good musical kind either.
No, not the good musical kind.
9.
Sanders on skipping White House Korea briefing, quote, I did not want to be part of a photo op.
This was submitted by DIY2 to our politics. D2? I don't know.
I don't know. So anyway, all 100 senators were invited to the White House for a special press briefing. It wasn't a press. No, that is incorrect. Wrong terminology. It was not a press briefing. Just a special briefing for the senators on the situation in North Korea. They were all going to be herded into a special room that is supposed to be super secure so that there's no problems with like cybersecurity or anything like that. Sanders sat out because he said that those briefings are normally not very informative at all. They're nothing but a gathering of everybody so that they can take a picture, and he doesn't need to be part of that because it's not beneficial to the country.
I like Sanders.
We'll just get everyone in one place.
He makes me so sad that we couldn't have him.
Yeah, everyone was, you know, kicking the Hillary train too hard.
It hurts. It hurts a lot.
It does. Alaska voted for Sanders in the primary.
Yeah, I know. That's the depressing part.
By like 83%.
We were so fucking ready.
I think, yeah. But I mean, the problem is that even if it was Sanders, Alaska is a pretty Republican state, so we probably would have went Trump anyway.
Yep. I don't know, man.
Sucks, don't it?
No, I don't know.
You don't know?
I think he can speak for the people.
Oh, I think he can too.
Given more of an a bit, like, so he conceded, and Hillary still got to go around and campaign more. So if he got to campaign more, I feel like he would have been able to sway.
Well, with as close as Hillary was, I think he might have been able to pull the small little victories that were needed that Hillary lost.
Like, Trump was afraid to debate him.
Yeah, because there was no winning that debate.
No, there wasn't. There was 100% scared.
There was so much fire you can throw at Clinton. There's very little to throw at Sanders.
Not without sounding like petty. A complete imbecile.
I'm not sure if you'll survive your White House term, herder.
He's like, you're just as old as I am.
Hey, what the hell, dude? You're fucking old, too.
Oh, what the fuck?
8.
UK startup uses recycled plastic to build stronger roads.
This was submitted by Mavia to our Futurology.
The future of the roads is plastic.
That's actually amazing, and I really appreciate that.
So basically, the way that conventional roads are made is that they're made using 90% rock and sand and 10% bitumen, which is a form of solvent. Like, it's kind of like a tar plastic that actually holds it all together. So what they've done is they've just replaced a lot of those materials with small itty-bitty little plastic beads that, when they're heated up the same way that you apply asphalt, they create a much stronger bond. And because they've replaced some of the rocks, it acts like additional bitumen without actually needing to be an oil-based substance. Plastic is already oil-based, but you understand what I mean. And so what that ends up being is that the roads are stronger and last longer, and they're better for the environment because it's
recycled.
Yep.
It's the big thing.
So it's another thing to do with all those goddamn bottles.
Mm-hmm. Instead of throwing them out, or instead of melting them down and reforming them into more bottles.
Yep. It's use them for roads.
You should use them for bridges. Use them for literally anything.
Just don't throw them in the goddamn trash.
Exactly. And be careful, because arson might actually set some shit aflame.
Yeah, right now, besides his own personal projects, the English county of Cumbria has adopted it for any new roadways that they intend to implement.
Where is Cumbria?
In England.
Okay, what part? Northern England, Southern England?
Eastern, in West? England.
I'm curious.
I'm looking it up.
Because there's like Northumberland. Is Cumberland by Northumberland?
I don't know, dog. It is smack dab in the middle, right? Well, okay. I guess it's technically in the northern part of England. So, like, shit. I don't know how to fuck to describe this. I'll just fucking throw it up in the goddamn thing, okay?
Sure. I'll see it in like an hour.
You'll see it in 10 seconds, you piece of trash. Oh my god. Why? Such a bitch. I'll see it in an hour. Oh my god, you're the worst. So anyway, it's this fucking...
It's been 10 seconds already.
Oh, it's on the screen.
No, it's not.
It's on... When I'm looking at...
There it is. Now it is.
Wow, yours is even more delayed than mine. Anyway, it's because you suck, that's all.
I'll kill you.
So, it's this area right here.
You want to be a statistic?
Are you, because you're going to kill me?
Yeah, and I see it.
Does that fall into a statistic of, like, number of people who kill their best friends? Doesn't that make you a statistic?
Yeah.
Ow! Jennifer in the chat room. Stronger bond like Sean Connery instead of Pierce Brosnan. She only says that because she knows that I like Pierce Brosnan.
Sucks to suck.
Like, she could have picked several of the other Bonds, but nope, had to pick Pierce Brosnan purely because she'd know it'd jab at me.
Dude, that's pretty piercing.
You, oh my fucking.
It's a pun.
You suck. That was really bad. Okay, it was all right. So yeah, plastic roads.
Yeah.
Get by today.
Seven.
Plastic beaches.
Workers at Chinese factory for Ivanka Trump's clothing paid $62 a week.
This is submitted by Loblogs to Our World News.
So, yikes. Well, here's the thing, right? Is like, as he, like, in America, we're like, oh, God, but there's been a full research, there's been a full investigation into it. And while the work conditions aren't great and they generally work pretty long days, they're technically being paid minimum wage in China.
Oh, okay. So they're, like, following Chinese law.
Yeah, I mean, as shitty as it sounds, this is also why people make a lot of stuff in China, because...
it's cheap as fuck.
Yeah, labor's...
you can buy people. They have so much fucking people.
Well, yeah, and if you only need to pay someone the equivalent of, like, $1 an hour compared to in America where, you know, $7.50 or something, mm-hmm. Yeah, you're gonna pick China on a money stance, and, well, that's what businesses fucking care about.
You want more money?
Build in China?
No, a yuan is the Chinese currency.
Oh, God damn it, man.
It's a pun.
Hate you. But they're going into more investigations just in Chinese labor in general to make sure that, because China doesn't like that it's getting such a negative connotation with the labor industry of, like, we just have sweatshops and everyone builds their factories over here. That's not what Chinese sound like. That's me being a dumbass American. Anyway.
You can't fucking write.
But so they've been looking into their entire, like, labor system. And this is just part of those reports. But it's easy to fucking point a gun at the... no, maybe not point a gun. That's not the right phrasing. But it's easy to shake a finger at the Trump family. Because almost all their stuff's made in China.
Right, and China's communist, largely, right?
Yeah, but so much stuff is made in China. Like, this is them being like, look, they pay the Chinese people dick. And it's like, well, actually, everyone that has their stuff made in China pays them dick.
It's kind of cheap housing, because they have to have a lot of it.
Yeah, I mean, there's lots of... What's the phrase that I'm looking for? There's lots of, like, good enough... things that are in China right now because they have so many people.
Yeah, exactly.
Which, I mean, it's a rough situation over there altogether. I'm not sure.
In some places.
Whoa, light. Nathan, put your head. Oh, there you go. No, stop it, you piece of shit.
Six.
Trump agrees not to terminate NAFTA at this time.
This was submitted by Mania for Beatles to Our World News.
NAFTA, otherwise known as the North America Free Trade Agreement, it is the trade agreement that allows us to freely trade between Canada and Mexico without really any problems, any tariffs, anything like that. It makes it easy for you to trade between those three countries, the countries that are on the North American continent. Trump was going to say that he was going to pull out of that he was going to discontinue it, that he was going to get rid of it completely. The problem is how damaging that would be to everyone's economy. It would wreck Canada's economy. It would wreck Mexico's economy, and it would hurt our economy real bad. It would completely decimate some states. You know how bad Alaska got decimated when the price of oil fell like 80%? Yeah, imagine that just for like 10 other states.
Yeah, that's pretty bad.
So,
except not everyone remembers that, Michael, because not everyone was there.
Where?
In Alaska.
I know. It was for you.
Oh. Oh, thank you.
But yeah, just imagine if your state was making $1 million and then suddenly was only making $200,000 and was still expected to run the same way. It doesn't work.
No, it doesn't. That's how like, MC Hammer went bankrupt.
And that's kind of what, like, luckily, Prime Minister Justin Trudeau and the President of Mexico, whose name escapes me all of a sudden... darn.
Look it up.
Enrique Peña Nieto, I hope I said that correct, they have convinced Trump to not back out of NAFTA and agreed to look at renegotiations on NAFTA.
Because they're both his greatest of friends now, right? Best friends.
I guess, but it's more...
they're both swell guys.
Technically, they are both swell guys.
Yeah, they are, but...
yeah, but they're your neighbors. Be nice to your neighbors. And I understand Trump's looking at all of our trade deals to try and figure out what doesn't benefit America and change it so it does. But simply canceling trade deals doesn't always help.
No, it just doesn't work.
I mean, he did pull out of the Trans-Pacific Partnership.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess that was all right.
Damn it, Josh is at the fucking door, and I'm... You piece of shit. I'm going to buzz him in just a second. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the little button here, and you're going to read the full topic. Stop beeping the door, you piece of shit.
All right.
So he beeps it again. Oh, my God. I wonder if he's listened to the show and is like, I can hear you. Okay, you read the full thing, okay?
Yeah.
Five.
North Korea, oh God, oh, so much pressure. North Korea agrees to first ever UN rights expert visit. This is submitted by Condor Box to Our World News. Ah!
Ah?
Ah!
Why did you say ah?
You're gonna have to listen to find out.
I'm not listening to fucking shit.
Well then, nobody tell him.
Did you read the whole thing, by the way? Yeah, we good?
Yes, I did.
Okay, so a UN rights expert is going to be investigating North Korea. This is specifically looking to make sure that their workers are being treated appropriately.
Oh, good.
I think Josh is trying to squeeze in here, I think is what he's trying to do.
I'm not trying anything.
You're going to grab that microphone, and I'm going to turn it on.
Woo.
No, it's not on yet. Now it's on.
Now it's on? Now it's on?
Yep. But there you go.
Check.
Yeah, you're here.
Okay, I'm here.
This is great for North Korea, in my opinion, because this is a step for them going, oh, okay, let's not be so, you know.
Well, and this is actually specifically looking at disabled people's rights to make sure that, you know, you're not infringing upon your broken citizens.
Yeah.
And
you don't want to be that guy, you know.
They're going to be there for a week. Most of that time is going to be spent in Pyongyang, and they are going to be doing a presentation at the end of the week that they're there.
Okay.
So we'll see. But people are looking at North Korea now, so hopefully that means good things.
Yeah, no, that's great. I'm excited.
You should be. So, Josh, welcome to the show. Guest, welcome to the show. How are you, sir?
I was going to say, damn right. Make sure you get the names right.
Guest?
Yeah, I'm doing okay. I actually had a really great day.
Good.
So.
I've adjusted the camera so that you fit in the frame better.
Oh, thank you. You're so sweet.
Just wanted you to feel at home.
I do.
Good. Wonderful. Joshua Schwahn has joined. Are you watching the show? You're spamming emojis while you're in the show.
Well, I mean, I figured, you know, I mean, you know.
Gotta keep up appearances, right?
That's right.
Yeah, pretty much.
I appreciate that, sir.
I have a reputation to protect as guest.
You heard about the Jennifer thing, huh? She tried to infringe upon your guestship.
It's called the guest rights.
No.
It's a Game of Thrones thing.
Is it?
Yeah.
God damn it.
I'm bigger and stronger.
That's why some guy's going to get his children fed to him.
Sure. Billionaire.
Illionaire.
Billionaire.
Dude, this dude's an illionaire, motherfucker. It's
fucking ill. I'm just fucking leaving it.
Hey, do you
guys
remember that old hit rapper, Charmillionaire or Chameleonaire, whatever the hell his name was?
Charmillionaire. Oh my god.
Charmillionaire.
Oh.
Well, that's it, folks.
He spits fire like a flamethrower.
Oh, that needs to be a Weird Al Yankovic song. Oh, hashtag Weird Al, hashtag get it done.
Billionaire Paul Allen has pledged $30 million towards permanent housing for Seattle's homeless.
This is submitted by Serial 007 to Our Uplifting News.
So, billionaire Paul Allen has put forth $5 million. The city of Seattle has put... Wait, hang on. Paul Allen has put forth $30 million. The city of Seattle is putting forth $5 million to build basically a big apartment complex that's going to house 100 of Seattle's homeless. Doesn't sound like much, but honestly, in the grand scheme of things, $35 million isn't that much money when it comes to trying to build a lot of housing.
Now, being from the Seattle area, I got to tell you, although it may just simply state that it's going to house 100 people, they're probably going to cram like 175 people into it.
Yeah, probably.
So, didn't Paul Allen die?
No.
Yeah, dude, he totally got his head axed open. An American Psycho.
God.
Oh my god.
Why do you do this?
Bad Nathan.
Bad. Dude, it was Jared Leto. That was Paul Allen.
I promise you, sir, next time I see you, rolled newspaper and spray bottle.
Aw, come on. You can't make me rub my nose in my own joke.
Spritz, bap.
No, we're just going to spray your tail, little Charmander.
That's rude. That could kill someone. That's a...
Charmillionaire, thank you.
Prison.
No. I'm not going to put it out. I'm just gonna make you feel it.
That's fucked up.
Can you feel it now, Mr. Krabs?
That's so fucked up.
Mr. Schwahn.
That's like going up to you and pulling off your fingernails.
You always put out.
I do?
Wink. Face.
I'm not you. Oh!
Burn! Burn.
But I
do. I do.
Noted.
Yeah, Paul Allen's dead.
No, he's not. Damn it. It is going to be the housing complex is going to be ran by a nonprofit. That nonprofit is not receiving funding of those $35 million. It will be funded by public and private donations. At least that's what they say.
By Mexican tariffs.
There are no building plans yet. They don't know where it's going or when it's going to be built. Just that they have money to do so now.
That's fucking sick.
That seems very democratic of them.
How
I mean, it is Seattle.
Is there a lot of homeless in Seattle, Josh?
Oh my God. Okay, so downtown Seattle is one of the few places in the country where you can literally be standing next to a billionaire and a homeless person on the same street corner.
Sick.
In fact, there's Second and Pike, I believe it is a downtown corner that has its own Twitter feed for the crazy ass shit. It's like its own little like vortex of Florida being channeled through there.
Oh, God.
Vortex of Florida? Why Florida?
Go to Google and type in Florida man dot dot dot.
Oh,
and
sure. Got it. Okay.
The level of crazy things that happen.
Yep. I got you. I understand now.
3.
Hiker found alive after 7 weeks lost in Himalayas.
That was submitted by That's Bush League to our news.
So, yeah, dude went hiking. This is from he was from Taiwan. Him and his partner went hiking. They got caught up in a snowstorm, ended up falling down a 100-meter ravine. We're still okay, and then managed to survive. Well, he survived for 7 weeks. His partner that was with him, she died 2 days before he was found.
Did he eat her?
No.
But they'll eat cats and dogs.
Sure.
I genuinely don't know. I'm being a dick.
The guy was very exhausted and very hungry, but he was still alive, and he's going to make a full recovery.
Well, that's fantastic. I'm sorry to hear about her.
7 weeks!
2 days!
Yeah, that's the sad part, right?
That's depressing. Not only because it's like a trip at the finish line type of thing, but at the same time, like,
you
terrible.
Survived 6 weeks and 5 days or whatever.
After falling down a ravine like that, yeah.
Yeah.
You don't watch Bear Grylls if you want to survive. Bear Grylls is an awful fucking survivalist.
No, you watch Survivor Man. Like,
sure.
Have you not watched Survivor Man?
I haven't Les had Stroud,
cable
right?
in
Les
7
Stroud?
Years.
Les Stroud's really good.
Like, Survivor Man was so much better than Bear Grylls, although, like, because one, he didn't have a camera crew. He did all of his own camera work. And two, like, Bear Grylls would always, like, make situations seem super extreme, and Survivor Man was like, actually, if you just do this, you should probably be fine for quite some time.
So, I'm loosely related to a survival TV show host.
And that person would be?
Please stay Steve Irwin.
No, he is, and I say loosely related because I'm not related by blood, Man, Woman, Wild. Have you watched that?
No.
Okay, so it's a dude and his wife, and they go off and live in the wild for a bit. It's Mike Hawk and his wife, who is a TV show hostess. I forget her name. But the main point is, his name's Mike Hawk.
No.
Mike Hawk.
Nope.
You're loosely related because your name is Nathan Scott Wood? Is that what it
no,
is?
No. I'm loosely related because his mother is dating my grandfather.
That's not loosely related, like, in the least.
That's stretching it. But you know what? Whatever.
I said loose. It's
no.
really loose.
Nope.
Gross. Oh
Sorry,
my,
dude.
I'm done. Trump's newly unveiled anti-immigrant hotline bombarded with reports of space aliens.
Spalians?
Yeah,
this was submitted by Caravan to our politics. Oh, my God.
Well,
we need... We need to take... This is the Goobax episode! Or Marklar episode!
See, what it is that he opened up a hotline that you can call to report either incidents or suspicious behavior of people that you either know or believe to be illegal immigrants. So people have been flooding that call line with stuff about space aliens.
Because UFOs and aliens.
Yeah.
They're illegal.
That's
They're
exactly what I would do.
As fucking snake-headed aliens.
I did not think
aliens.
Of that. That's, but it, that just sounds like a very guest thing to do.
That would be amazing.
Yeah.
So much so that the...
What's the hotline?
Oh, I don't know. I could probably find it.
Let's make a phone call.
If it's even still up. We're not making a phone call right now.
Are you doing a live phone call?
I was going to say, we'll do it live. But, no, but he didn't want to.
Well, because it, like, there's no way that that audio is going to go well into these.
Rude.
It's bad radio.
You're not wrong.
You're bad radio.
You're not wrong.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean it. That was kind of rude.
But you can totally just, you know... Call this. And just, who fucking cares? Oh my God, Trump, you're getting ridiculous. Like, fine, you won't let me ban the immigrants. I'll set up a hotline where you can tell me how bad they are.
Call in. That, and then he's going to use it for statistic numbers and everything. He's going to be like, oh, these people, that's why people are fucking calling in with aliens.
Yep. I'm going to spell that wrong, aren't I?
Yeah.
Totally fucking did.
Totes my goats.
There we go. I got it. Don't worry. I know how to do this.
One.
Word.
Net neutrality.
Oh, this is submitted by a lot of people. We're going to go with Evan FFTF to our technology. Do you want me to read the other ones?
No, it's fine. I'm just putting them here for additional information for people that want to click the links.
Because there's like three other people.
So what are they doing this time?
So the FCC has been, they have a new head, right? And that head wants to completely undo the net neutrality laws set in place in 2015. These are the laws that say things like your ISP can't throttle your speed for specific websites. They're not allowed to do specific types of monitoring. They can't change the access to, like, basically they're not allowed to fuck with the internet for the sake of them wanting to have control over it.
Which makes it so that no company can then in turn pay an ISP to show favoritism.
Correct.
Yeah.
So basically what those rules do is it keeps the control over the internet as a whole out of the control of the people who provide your internet. Your internet service providers, people like Comcast, Time Warner Cable, AT&T, etc. Now, the FCC says that they have no right to have those rules, so those rules are going to be overturned from the original ruling in 2015 under the Obama administration.
I miss that man.
Yeah, I'm right. They have already received massive pushback from this because right now it's already hard enough to not be dicked over by your internet service provider because they have full control over a lot of things already and you don't have the option to go somewhere else. I have one choice at my house. One. I can only get GCI. And in the four places I've lived in Anchorage, I have only had one choice. And it fucking sucks because...
Pretty shitty.
Yeah, and it's like, oh, you want internet? Well, this is your only option. This is how much you're going to pay.
That's all right. Bobby's got two.
Yeah, I wish I had access to a friggin' MTA.
He's got one for unlimited download. And he's got one for fast speeds for gaming.
Which, honestly, now with the way the GCI is set up, that's not even necessary. They should just cancel their MTA thing.
Yeah.
Because, I mean... Even if you cap out the terabyte of data, which is not easy to do unless you are downloading, like, I could if I really put my mind to it, but damn, that would be difficult. And even once you hit that cap, you still get 10 megs down, which is more than fast enough for gaming.
Well, to be fair, I may or may not have allegedly, prior to my move to Anchorage, allegedly pirated about 200 gigs a month.
Yeah, that's only a fifth of a terabyte, though.
Yeah.
And, like, I mean, I could easily, allegedly, pirate, like, a terabyte, but eventually you're gonna either, one, run out of storage space, or two, run out of things to fucking download.
That's what happened to me, is I'm now, like, I've only got a couple of TV shows I allegedly need to catch up on. That's about it.
Yeah.
I've got a couple, too.
Oh, I know Bobby could do it, but it's a matter of how often are you actually doing it.
But, I mean, to be fair, I've got 20 terabytes of storage at my house.
You could fill that.
Yeah, easy.
But see, here's the thing is that, well, with like downloaded video, it'd actually be pretty hard. But things like my video production and my audio files and stuff, those take up some fucking space. Production stuff will devour storage space.
Oh, absolutely.
You gotta have so much space in your cloud, dude.
I actually just have external hard drives because clouds, they're all expensive.
And not only that, they're notorious for corrupting data.
Yep.
At least video and audio data. I mean, if you've got documents, sure, but I don't trust them for any of my digital media.
And I just use Google Drive for documents and spreadsheets because Google Docs and Google Sheets works pretty damn well. And you can have an infinite number of them of any size as long as they're that format. Google doesn't count it against your storage space. Back onto the topic, though. So the problem...
Right.
What? Oh, the problem with this is that if they revoke those rules, it gives the ISPs full control over the decisions involving... What, you looking at the camera?
Yeah.
Okay.
Whoever's watching us.
Oh, okay. Full control over the internet as a whole. And what this does is this makes it where they can just do whatever the fuck, literally whatever they want. And initially, when you're like, well, what could they do? Well, it could be like, okay, well, you know what? Well, we are through Comcast, and Comcast has signed a multi-billion dollar deal with Netflix, and you will get fast as fuck speeds through Netflix, but we're going to throttle your speeds through Hulu.
Yeah.
And that's not fair to Hulu. And under the current rules, they can't do that. If they revoke those rules, they totally could. And the other thing is there has already been 800 startup companies that have signed a letter that said, do not do this, FCC, because what it would do, it would allow the internet service providers, and one of the main ways that startups get, you know, attention is through the internet. The internet service provider, breaking no rules whatsoever, could just turn off easy access to a startup's website and essentially kill them if they didn't like them.
Oh, absolutely. God forbid somebody tweets that they had a bad experience with that ISP, and now that ISP could just make it to where loading that website's like trying to load a flash-heavy website in 2001.
Yeah, you just you get removed. You don't exist anymore.
That's really rude.
And this is why it's a concern.
Rude.
And the head of
rude.
FCC is like, we are going to do this. I am willing to fight through this. And everyone is like, fuck you, dude. No.
Yeah, let's not have that happen.
We will see what ends up happening. I don't know what the fight is here, how you fight this, but it does need to be fought because let me put it plainly to you. This will wreck your use of the internet. And in zero way benefits the consumer. This only benefits the internet service provider companies. Only. Nobody else.
It is a huge downfall, in fact, if you are not an internet service provider company.
Well, and not just the startups, but Al Franken, who is one of the senators for the United States of America, has already come out and said he will not stop fighting this. Because he knows just how detrimental it is to everyone. But the head of the FCC, which is really just a overpaid person that is acting in the good light of the service providers, he's not actually in it for the consumer. He's in it for the people that are giving him a lot of money, and there's evidence to support just how much money they have given him.
It's a lie.
Yeah, this guy Al Franken has come out and said, "I will fight this tooth and nail as long as there is a battle to be fought."
Isn't that an instant?
Sure.
I can't wait for him to give them the Frankensteiner.
I meant tooth and nail.
I know. Okay. What you're talking about, magic cards. He's talking about wrestling. You both are terrible people. So yeah, keep an eye on the whole net neutrality fight with the FCC, because it's going to be an interesting time, and who knows what's going to happen from it.
Yeah, I tried as hard as I could to take active part from a poor college student's, you know, seat back in 2015. And if it comes to it again, I'll be doing the same thing, because holy shit.
It's fun times, right?
Oh, yeah. Oh, grand. Great. Fantastic.
The best, even.
America.
Yeah, just straight best. Make America great again.
I'm Mr. Meeseeks. Look at me.
Hey, Nathan, what'd you care about in the last 24 hours?
So, there's an interesting little article on the Squared Circle subreddit about...
Hang on, pause. Squared Circle is a subreddit devoted to professional wrestling. Continue.
Right. because it's a square, but you know, you're getting in the circle.
You're getting in the ring.
Yeah, in the ring. And it's about Dave Bautista.
Dave Bautista, professional wrestler, now turned popular actor playing Drax the Destroyer on Guardians of the Galaxy.
Sure. Right. Right. Continue.
So, through a lot of pictures and guesswork and measurement based off of his size, they've roughly given us the size of his dick.
Why? Why?
Because these are the things that the internet cares about.
Yeah, I...
Dude, okay, hang on. You don't underestimate the power of Reddit or 4chan, okay? Because they will go to the ends of the earth. 4chan spent time triangulating and following the paths of airplanes to track down Shia LaBeouf's freedom flag in the middle of nowhere in South Africa.
Well, I heart 4chan, but I've been using 4chan since 1999, 2000, something like that.
I have never touched 4chan, what? And I will not do so.
I don't know. It probably was a little bit later than that. It probably just feels like it's been that long. I've been using it since I was a kid.
The only good thing to come out of 4chan is D&D green text.
So, do you want to know how long his talk is?
How dare you?
Okay, can you even give me three positive things that have come from 4chan?
One is other green text stories.
Four panel comics.
I'll give you that one.
So let's say green text stories in general.
No.
Do you want other than what you just said?
Because anything can be a green text story. A story is a story. Just green text is told.
That's like saying a picture with words on it is a meme.
You're not that far off. Anyway, continue. I'll give you four panel comics.
Rude.
Advice animals.
First of all, it was a good community project for people who felt socially outcasted. Two, it provided an anonymous outlet to start up what is commonly referred to as Hacktivision.
Boxy.
Did Boxy come from 4chan?
Old fags remember.
Yeah. Wait, what is this about old fags? Boxy's amazing.
4chan
yeah,
is one
I,
of the
I know. That's,
4chan is
that's
one of the original forums that really promoted trolling. Like a
moot
lot.
Moot doesn't even own 4chan anymore. That's a moot point.
Is it?
It's a pun.
So anyway, Nathan, you never got around to it. How big is Dave Bautista's dick?
Yeah,
also Advice Animals. Advice Animals was great. Dave Bautista's dick is roughly 8.1 inches, giving a margin of error by 0.03 inches.
0.03 inches?
What? Yeah.
That is incredibly specific.
And we don't know that stuffing or that the bulge could be enhanced by CGI
because
or
he's
anything
had
like that.
Pictures, he's had pictures with a raging boner in a suit.
So, first off, I like seeing that someone just joined the chat, which means they just turned on the video, which means that they entered the fucking show right as we're talking about the size of a wrestler's
dick. I'm
going to
send you a picture of an outline of his thick, girthy cock.
Don't do that, please. Don't send it to me.
You need to send it in Hangouts, because I'm not opening it in Skype.
Oh, you're right. It sucks.
Because it just...
I hate it.
I don't care if you hate it. That's nice. I'm so hungry.
Yeah, okay.
So,
look at that thick, girthy cock.
And that's how you get taken off of Facebook, everybody. Just like that. Did they actually wow, they totally
they
did.
They outlined his girth.
All right, so we're going to...
I say it's a cucumber.
You think that's a cucumber just hidden in there?
I don't think so.
You put that on the show?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Okay. Oh, please. This show is already marked explicit.
That's fair. Okay. At least there's that.
Like, I mean, there's no getting around it. Like, I'm pretty sure I opened the word with fuck, goddamn it, son of a bitch, shit, I fucked it all up.
I was at the gym when you guys started. I'm sorry I missed your intro.
Oh, that's okay. Most of the live listeners normally miss the intro because, well...
But I love the intro.
That's nice. I'm glad you love it, but most of the time people miss it because they have to get in here.
That's true. I want to say something. It's understandable him having a giant girthy cock while
How many times are you going to say that tonight?
A lot.
Okay.
While sitting out there in front of the audience, because it's incredibly like exciting to be in front of an audience. It's a lot of blood running through your body.
I got to tell you, man, I've done a lot of public speaking. I've given multiple speeches. I've given multiple presentations, and not one time have I become erect because of the excitement. And
I'm just saying, I enjoy public speaking,
and I'm relatively good at it, and nope, no hard penis.
I'm surprised he's still standing with how much blood has to be in his girthy cock.
God damn it. Hey, Josh.
Yeah.
What did you care about in the last, I don't know, couple weeks?
Dave Bautista's.
Oh my god.
My girlfriend brought me lunch today.
That's a good thing to care about.
Was it
sausage?
No, it was a bacon cheeseburger from, I think, Tommy's.
Was it thick and girthy?
Dude.
Not like Dave Bautista's cock.
Tom's burgers are really good.
No, it was really good, and I actually messaged her like 2 minutes after, because she just dropped it off and left. But
Haley Rocky like, missed the discussion.
Where did you get this burger? I need to know. I need to have it in my mouth again at a later date.
Is that your intention? Is to put nice, thick, girthy meat in your mouth again at a later time?
Yes.
Good.
It's so unfortunate because Haley Rocky showed up right after we got done talking about.
Do me a favor.
What's up?
Hit the button.
Which one?
The one for you.
One for me?
And Mr. Schwahn, what have you cared about in the last since the last time I was here?
I swear to God, if it's not thick, girthy cock, I'm going to be pissed.
I don't want to disappoint him.
We're grown-ass adults laughing at penis jokes.
We are all dudes. It is a sausage fest in here full of some big, thick, girthy penises, okay?
Jen!
All right.
Jen, get over here.
Ah, what?
I'm being assaulted.
You're not on the show.
Some pork swords, if you will.
Pork swords? I tried out a Wii U.
That's a ballistic missile.
So there's two things. Since you're here, this motherfucker is an asshole.
Yeah. What'd I do?
He's trying to buy me a fucking couch.
Oh well, I'm not trying.
You're an asshole. I love you.
I love you
but
too.
You're an asshole. Otherwise though, I tried out a Wii U emulator today, and whoo, that could use some improving.
Why are you emulating them? Why aren't you just buying the system?
Didn't we just talk at the beginning of the show how broke both of us are?
Yeah.
Wii U's are probably like
$25 by now. Workout,
correction! Wii U's are getting more expensive. What?
What?
They stopped production on them, but they're still a sought-after system.
No, and fuck that. No, they're not a GameCube. They're not allowed to do that.
GameCubes are cheap as shit.
What?
Yeah, you can get a GameCube for like $50.
Bullshit.
Okay, I can't take you to a store where they sell one right now.
In the Anchorage area, they're being hoarded.
In the Anchorage area, you could get one for $50.
I have a quest.
Anyway.
I used to have one.
Do you want to go on an adventure?
Not right now. Is it an adventure to get food?
Ooh,
hey, beer. Actually, I want to go on your adventure because I also have to find a a Nintendo Oxford, so that I can drink and play Mario Kart.
Beer! Jesus Christ, max out the fucking microphone. God damn.
You'll fix it in post.
Sure, whatever.
I don't think he will.
Nope.
I'm gonna run
Have
it
you met him?
Hey!
No.
I do the work, motherfucker. What do you do?
And see, that's
I've offered to do
a comics trick that we do when we refer to a thing that we talked about last time. Brings it back around.
Remember
that last time I was here, I did the whole like fix it in post.
Oh yeah, and I
went on the diatribe,
shit.
And you were like, I don't fix shit. But God damn it!
I do run a bunch of post processing on the audio, so it normally sounds a lot better if you listen to it through your phone or something than if you listen to it live, because I do post processing. But I normally don't do additional work past normally the standard processes that I do run will fix most problems.
Some of you may die. but that can we, is what, a risk what sound do you want on the soundboard? I'm willing to take.
I really want like a really nice clean like chop from wrestling.
Sure. I mean, I can try and get one.
Good.
Kerslippity slap.
So, but the Wii U.
It has to be a Ric Flair one. So afterwards, it'd be like, woo!
The Wii U emulator, like it had two modes of like running fucking great, beautiful, smooth, buttery. Like it was running great and like
buttery. It was all yellow.
And then it would sometimes move into. I'm chugging real hard, and the audio would go from, like, the audio was never great. Like, sometimes the audio would click and clack and stuff, but then...
You click and clack and stuff.
Yeah, I know I do. You want me to crack my neck? Because, I mean, it'll fucking sound like you goddamn grinded some bones.
Is it Nathan? Is Nathan the one that doesn't like that?
I don't know. What? Jennifer's not fond of it.
All right.
I don't like what?
Cracking bones.
I don't like cracking fingers all that much, except I do it a lot because I hate things like fingers getting hurt.
So I was specifically trying to play Bayonetta 2, and the cutscenes would run okay, but sometimes the cutscene video would jerk for a moment, which then would desync the video and the audio, so the audio would be ahead of the video.
You were choosing to play Bayonetta, the Wii U version?
Because Bayonetta 2 is only on Wii U.
That's gross.
Yep.
Why?
Because Nintendo paid for it to be made because Sega had no money.
Sega has no money.
Just
in general.
And, like, the gameplay would work all right, but then, like, if we would have to, like, slow down, because there's a lot of slow-mo in Bayonetta, like, it would jerk for a moment, and the audio would just be like, until the slow-mo quit. And then, like, as soon as the slow-mo was over, like, as soon as witch time was done, it would be running all right again, and then you dodge something. And I was like, all right, well, this apparently isn't quite optimized enough. I'll wait for them to fix it a little bit more. Incidentally, if anyone's got a Wii U that they're not too attached to, that they don't mind if I borrow for a year, hit me up.
I literally just gave my
actually,
to my
I think
brother.
I think I know someone.
Brendan?
Yeah.
Cool. Oh.
And, like, Brendan, do the thing.
And like, I'll be honest, I will probably be borrowing it for like a year because that's the type of person I am.
I mean, at least you're okay with that.
Of course I'm okay with it. It's if the person whose Wii U it is okay with
that's
it.
That's fair. I'm always late to things.
All right. So now that this is over, are we done? Can we go home now?
Sure.
Yeah, I want to watch this video about this guy battling with a pseudo-wudo.
I'm going to go get some beer.
You don't want to watch a video about some thick, girthy cock?
That's what the pseudo-wudo is.
God damn it. All right, everybody. If you're still here, if you want to support the show to get Nathan some thick, girthy cock.
Well, I already have one. Thank you.
We both know that's not true.
Patreon.com/dailyinternet. Otherwise, follow us on social media, Twitter, Instagram, and
it's
Facebook.
It's in my drawer.
All of it's at iReaditcast. Share us on... don't share this episode.
No, share the hell out of this episode.
No.
Post it on Pornhub.
You probably could. There was a penis involved. Yeah. Where was I? Who fucking cares? Kevin MacLeod does our music at incompetech.com. That is it, everybody. That is your 278th dose of the internet. I am Michael Schwahn.
And I am Nathan Wood.
And I am Guest.
Have a good day, everyone.
Goodbye.